Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah! 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 Holy Spirit, fire! 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 Holy Spirit, fire of God! Fire of God consume my enemies! The fire of the Holy Spirit fight for you! The fire of the Holy Spirit in a wall of protection around you. The fire of the Holy Spirit is your high tower. The fire of the Holy Spirit will consume the devil and his demons. The fire of the Holy Spirit will swallow up all your enemies and consume them. The fire of the Holy Spirit will fight for you and defend you. The fire of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. You can't fight me. You can't fight me. Greater is he that's in me than who is in the world. I said, greater is he that's in me than who is in the world. I say the kingdom of darkness got to be demolished. The kingdom of darkness and the members of the satanic kingdom don't fall on their knees. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah! 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 The word of God said in the book of James chapter 4, resist the devil. I said resist the devil. Resist the devil and he shall flee from you. Resist him above all. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but by principalities, powers, rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. I said the war is a spiritual war. The war is not a carnal war. The war is not a cussed out, pulled out, drowned out, punched out, kicked out war. But the war is a spiritual war. You want to fight the war according to what the Father say in the Bible. That's the way you fight the war. Singing psalms, praises, fasting, and praying, and spreading the word. The word is your weapon. I said the word of God is your weapon. I say the word of God is your weapon. I say you are a battle axe. You are the battle axe of the Lord. And with thee, God will break down, destroy nations. I said, you are about life for the Lord. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah. I said, you are a child of God. You are precious in His eyes. You are a child of God. Children of God, you have the power. You have power of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is upon you. He has called you to heal the brokenhearted, to build the waste places, to preach the gospel and deliver His people. People of God, you are somebody in Christ Jesus. You have the power of the Holy Spirit. You got the power in your tongue. Death and life is in your tongue. You have the power to call judgment upon your enemies. You have the power to condemn every wicked deed, every wicked heart. You see, you're sitting in heavenly places and you don't even know the power that God has given you. God has given you all power. Jesus said, greater works we shall do. I said, greater works we shall do. Don't be afraid of the enemy. Don't be afraid of them in the physical realm. Don't be afraid of them in the spirit, because you have dominion and power over both. You got dominion and power in the physical realm. You got dominion and power in the spiritual realm. Maintain a clean heart. Live righteously. Live in truth. Live in the spirit in Jesus Christ's name. Let your profession of Christianity be a true profession. Live holy. God is holy and you must live holy. Christians are not perfect. And many days they judge us and they condemn us. But God says, for every judgment they call against you, you got the power to reverse it. You have power. I say God has given you power. God has given you power. He will fight for you. He will fight for you financially, for your marriage, for your fiancé. He will fight for your children. He will fight for you. He will fight for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. When the battle comes, you will know. You will know when you are in a war. You will know when you are under attack. You will know. God does not hide nothing from us. God is a true God. God has chosen you. You are a chosen vessel. Let nobody tell you nothing different. You walk as an ambassador. Raise your back up. Push your chest out. Lift up your head. You are a child of God. A royal priesthood. Set aside for good works, for good things. You are more than a conqueror. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of His testimony. I say they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. The only way you can overcome this wicked world and the wickedness in this world, the spirit of confusion, is through the word of God. The counselor can't do it because the counselor is a Luciferian. They practice psychology and sociology and all the other metaphysical. They do hypnosis. So you can lose weight and you can start fighting. But I'm telling you, there's a greater one. The one who created heaven and earth. According to the book of John chapter 1. That one, his name is Jesus. All things was created by him, through him. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the only way. He is the only way. Man may say this and that, but the only way is Jesus. Jesus is the only way. The way out of your poverty, the way out of your sickness, the way out of your bondage, the way out of your confusion. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the light. No man, I say no man shall enter into the kingdom. I say no man shall enter into the kingdom of God except through Jesus. And today, we give thanks to the Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just want to thank you. We thank you that you have protected us, that you have covered us, that you have brought us, that you woke us up in our right mind. I remember my name, my date of birth, everything about my family, me. Oh, I thank you, Lord, like I'm not a lunatic, I'm not crazy. I thank you that you have rebuked the devourer. I thank you, Father, that you have cast down principalities and powers. I thank God that you take vengeance for me against my enemy. Oh, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, because man will fail you. I say, if you put your trust in man, it will fail you. Man is bound to betray you. Man will betray your trust. But put your trust in the Lord. Put your trust in the Word of God. Put your trust always in the Lord, and he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. Oh, he will be with you to the end. Whatever you're going through, I tell you, God is with you. He will figure out a fight. He will pull you out. He will support you. He will pick you up. The Word of God said, "Down the righteous man falls 7 times. The Lord will pick him up." I say he's ready to pick you up from wherever you are. He will pick you up right now. Whatever problems you're going through in your business, in your finances, in your work, in your marriage, with your children, whatever, have faith in God. Put your faith in God. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Touch their heart, O Lord. Heal them, O Lord. Oh, wash them, O Lord. Deliver, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. And today we're going to turn our precious book to the book of Isaiah 55. Isaiah 55 is a book of redemption. God is a redeemer. He's a deliverer. The churches have failed us because the lust of money. The churches have become the house of harlotry, a house of den, a demon, a synagogue of Satan. The church has failed to give us direction, to teach us, to deliver us. The church has failed us. But God has never failed us. What we're supposed to learn in the church would rather you learn it in the street. They will say you need to be street smart. They will tell you, if you was a drug dealer, you will be able to teach. But I tell you today, the devil is a liar and the father of all lies. The Word of God teaches us how to do deliverance. The Holy Spirit that dwells in you, teaches you, and guides you to all things. The gifts of the Holy Spirit is given to you to deliver those who are in trouble. The gifts of the Holy Spirit is not the power for you. It is the power of deliverance. It is the power to edify the body of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit gifts, the Holy Spirit power is for edification of the church, to build the church up. The church is the people. The church is not the wall and the roof and the pastor behind the pew pulpit. The church is the human beings. The body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. That's where God dwells. He's supposed to dwell in your body. Confusion got to be cast out. Witchcraft, voodoo, oaths, sacrifice have to be cast out. There are so many Christians living demons, confusion, and torment. There are so many Christians who need clarity. They are confused. They never pick up the Bible and read. There are so many Christians that need a personal relationship with the Lord. There's so much anointing that is being wasted every day. Because the anointing of God upon their life is not being sharpened. The anointing of God got to be built up. You know, when you're cooking, you put the food to cook, and the cook gotta be, as you cook the food, you keep pouring seasoning, onions, you keep putting all your different ingredients in that pot with that chicken or that beef, you keep cooking it till it tenderizes, till all the seasonings cook together, you keep pouring pouring water, whatever ingredients you need, your vinegar, your wine, you keep pouring in that food. And when that dish is ready, that dish is so delicious. And that meat, or that is tender for the palate, and it's good. The same thing with the Christian. You've got to be seasoned. The Word of God got to season you. Got to pour upon you. The Holy Spirit gifts got to be perfected in you. It got to mature. Perfected me maturity. It got to season it. It got to kneel the kneel when you're baking bread. When you're making biscuits, you put the flour. You add the ingredients, the baking powder, the yeast. You put the butter, the oil, the water, and you kneel. You kneel to you. Get it to start fermenting, and then you can cook the biscuit, but you just can't take the flour and throw it in the oven. And that is what happened in the church today. There's no discipline. There's no sanctification. There's no purification. There's no deliverance. There's no edification in the church today. There's no holiness in the church today. We serve a holy God. God is a spirit. He's not an image in a picture with a beard. He's not some woman dressed up in white and blue, celeste, queen of the heaven or queen of the sea. He's not a stone or some type of African mass or God or whatever, or he, she, or Lilith, or whatever they call it. But God is a spirit. And he is holy, 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 holy. Even you have pastors comparing themselves and bishops to God. You got men and women calling themselves God sent. And you look at them and you see demons. I said the spirit of discernment. It's the spiritual eyes and ears. You need to pray that God will give you discernment. The Holy Spirit discernment, that you be able to recognize the false church from the true church, the sow, the wolf from the sheep, the goat from the lamb. You need the power of discernment. You need, because they will hypnotize you with their sociology, their metaphysical science, that will hypnotize you with their psychology and humanistic and doctrines of devil and demon by pulling out all these long words, blah, 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 but no power. I already told you the signs that should follow the people who love God and live in right. Yeah, he's such a good pastor. You know, my grandmama was underneath him. He's such a good man. And his wife, she's so sweet. She can bake them sweet potato pies. And, oh, they're such a good people. And the wife, she was over all the Eastern stars in the church. And, you know, my aunties and all of them was Eastern stars. And here he was a Freemason, Prince Paul. And all the men and the deacons was, then you claim that that's a man and a woman of God? They got a sticker on the back of their car, like a circle. Look and see how much covenants they have. How many circles have the lodges they don't sold their soul to? Blood covenants. Oaths. Evil rituals and sacrifices. That's what they sold themselves to. And they put on their car. So proud of themselves. And when they see another one in the parking lot at the mall, they lift up their hand and go like this and that. And I look and I say, look at the devil. That's the devil kingdom. These are devil people. And the other one will say, Pastor, so and so. Yes, deacon, those are your leaders. The Luciferians over you, directing you into receiving a satanic prophecy, a satanic covering, and living under satanic manipulation. Have mercy, Jesus, upon us. Let us teach. Isaiah 55, verse 1. Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters, and he that hath no money, come ye buy and eat, yea, come buy wine and milk without money, without price. Hallelujah. I said we're going into a millennium. The millennium of God is coming down to this earth. The millennium is a 1,000 years of peace upon this earth. And the one that God has ordained to bring the millennium to this earth is Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, Emmanuel, our Lord, our Savior, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. I say the millennium is coming, which is contrary to the Luciferian prophecy that we have been taught year after year, song on us, the flower doctrine. How comes God saying his word that at the seventh trumpet, the millennium is coming down with first resurrection, the army of the Lord, and the first resurrection? 1,000 years of teaching, 1,000 years of peace upon the face, all nations, all people. Amen. 2. Where do you spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which is satisfieth not? Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness, in abundance. In abundance. This is the land of abundance. But something is wrong. When people have been cast out of their homes and still losing their homes and becoming homeless, why the leaders in this nation handed over $700 billion to the same mortgage lenders and banks that embargo and foreclose on these homes? Wicked bankers, wicked lenders, wicked mortgage lenders who have made the people of this land homeless, who have made people of this land jobless, carless, foodless. Do you see why God is going to punish America? The word of God said, if my people will humble themselves and pray, I will heal this land. They are not humble enough even to pray to God to have mercy upon them and their own children. So when the storm is coming and the billows and the tornadoes and the thunders and the lightning and the earthquakes, that's when they're going to start crying out. Aftermath, we saw it, Hurricane Sandy. In the same particular area where they practice Macumba, Santeria, all of you don't understand what's going up in that area with the Italianos. You think you know. Study that you may find yourself approved. Santeria is a religion from Italy. It is an Italian version of voodoo. It was introduced to during the Palo Yombe and the Dorimani culture in West Africa. The Dorimani king came from the east. He was a black Arab. The Palo Yombe king came from the east. He was a black Arab. They all are the ones who enslave our people, the native Africans. There are two types of Africans in Africa today. You got the native African and you got the black Arab African. Two types. That's all voodoo was raised up because they gave them the liturgy. Sulinamis, the mother of Babylon, the great harlot, the queen of the heaven, they call her Ishtar, Ashtoreth, Asherah, Esther. The Babylonian queen. She is the mother harlot in Babylon. She was the mother of Nimrod, and she turned around and married her own son. Worse than Jezebel. The bloodline of Jezebel. The Mesopotamian, the Babylonian queen. Study that you may find yourself a truth. Some of those same practices, some of those same ancient traditions are here today in America. The first set of people, the pilgrims that came into this nation, they were ushered in by those who already was here. There were already Hebrews and Christians here. So when they came in, the stars told them, these people are coming. They already knew. In some of the tribes, like the Bannock tribe, but they tried to completely wipe out of America, the Bannock people. There was one of the people who ushered in, fed them, gave them, let them kill the lice off their body, gave them food and raiment, sewed clothes and taught them how to sew winter clothes and jacket and leather, filled them, fed them bison, fish, turkey. And the same Christians, one family, there's one people that came here after, looking for gold, looking for riches, and turn around and say, you know what? Take these guns and kill them because they're going to rape your daughters and they're going to have sex with your daughters and they're going to marry into your daughters. You're going to have bastards. You're going to produce bastards, mixed breed. The word bastard means mixed breed. The word bastard does not mean out of wedlock. It was used during slavery as out of wedlock. But when you research the word bastard, you go back all to the Hebrew. And it means interracial, when somebody intermixed. And that's what happened during slavery. There was raping the woman from all races. All races, the Inquisitors, the Romanovs, the Sanhedrin Council, the Jesuits, the Dominican Order, the Mother Confessor, the nuns was a woman. She was a torturer. She tortured the children of God. The witches were burning the Christians and calling the Christians witches. So the witches were burning people of God to the stake. But we serve a righteous God, a God that cannot lie. The same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It says here in verse 3 of Isaiah 55, incline your ear and come unto me, and your soul shall live, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even show mercies of David. The shepherd boy has become a king. David was a shepherd boy, walking around without no shoes, with a staff in his hand. The lion took one of his lambs. He pried open the mouth of the lion and bam, and punched him. It was the power of God, the Spirit of God. David, the shepherd boy, has become a king. Goliath, from Genesis chapter 6, a house bred with a fallen angel. When a fallen angel slept with a woman, he produced two types. What we call today small people, midget, and giants. He produced misfits, crazy murderers, rapists. That's what the gene is all around the earth. The gene has been planted in every race. Because if you study and you go deep in the Hebrew, in the Masora, in Genesis chapter 6, and you study the book of Genesis, which is the foundation, the Penta, the first five books, is the foundation for every Christian. Don't believe them when they tell you the old is abolished. No, without the old, we will not have the new, because the foundation of the new is the old. And without the old, we will not have the new, and the book is confirmation. Of the old, the new just confirm all the prophecies that was given. Even the birth of Jesus so many thousands of years, the Messiah. Rebellious women that would not submit to men to teach them have been taught by the best. Have been taught by anti men. Have been taught the best. Don't think it was a woman who taught me. A little woman taught me it 6-7 years, but it was men of God. Submit yourself. Submit yourself to God. Submit yourself to people of God. And this certain woman passed through my life. I blew a trumpet. Wake up. Straighten up, soldier. You be called by God. But I'm only 17. You're going to do exploits. Great things. I saw you in the spirit, bringing back the dead to life, just like Elijah. Me? I'm nobody. You are somebody in Christ Jesus. Walk in what God has ordained. You see, giving you a word of confirmation, not divination. Prophecy is to confirm the word of God in your life and teach you the word of God. Teach you the way a prophet, a true prophet, teach you the way a truth. A true prophet, a true prophetess, give you the word and teach you and deliver you. A true prophetess of God will deliver you. A true man of God, a true prophet of God is a teacher of God. He does not use divination. He does not use witchcraft. God does reject divination. Read Deuteronomy chapter 13. God is against witchcraft and procrastination. Many Christians are linked to that spirit. They need deliverance. Verse 4. Behold, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and commander to the people. It is God that promotes your business. I said promotion don't come from the north, the south, or the east, or the west, but promotion coming from the Lord. He will promote you in your job. He will promote you in your education. He will promote you. The beginning of wisdom is the fear of God. We have to be careful that we don't blaspheme his holy name. We got to be fearful that we don't become heretics and apostates and commit sacrilege. All in the name of grace. You are the grace. Forget about the commandments. We no longer honor the commandments. The commandments is good. Jesus said he did not come to destroy the law, but he came to fulfill the law. The laws are good. Thou shalt not commit adultery. It brings us back into remembrance to honor God and sanctify him and make him holy. Thou shalt not be covetous, neither thy neighbor's home, nothing that belongs to other people, neither their husband, neither their wife, neither their servant, neither their handmaid, neither their jewelry, neither their car. Covetousness is a sin. Six things the Lord hated, and seven is an abomination. Verse 5, behold, thou shalt call a nation that knowest not, and nations that know it not thee, shall run unto thee because of the Lord, that God. And for the Holy One of Israel, for he that glorified thee. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. This is the time. We are in the sixth trumpet. You know what the 666 means? They took it from the Bible. God gave it to us, to the saints. As a sign, the sixth trumpet, that's when Satan and the fallen angels are going to be cast down to this earth out of the bottomless pit. The sixth seal, when he starts running around, that seal is going to be open. And the sixth vial, when all the things start to be pouring out, he's coming to make your life a living hell for those who don't love the Lord, those people who don't seek God, those people who do not study the Word of God, those people who like to call themselves Christian and members of this denomination. They do not have a relationship with God. They have a relationship with their denomination and their pastor and their choir and the deacons. They attend to meetings and Bible studies, and they never learn nothing. Their eyes are shut blue because the devil has blinded them under a satanic covering of darkness. They believe in a satanic prophecy of hope. I said, the Lord is your hope. The Word is your hope. The blood of Jesus is your hope. The only condition to enter the kingdom of God is to confess your sins. Repent. 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 The kingdom of God is at hand. I receive salvation. Believe in Jesus Christ as the Son of God. That he died for the sins of this world. That is the condition. Everything else is man-made. Everything else man added on. It's called religion. It's called philosophies. It's called humanistic behavior and relations, sociology, psychology. It's called the metaphysical science of the demonic realm, rituals, sacrifice, oaths. That's what it's called. Blood covenants. That's what it's called. It's man-made. It's satanic and it's demonic. And if you bow your knees to any so-called prophet or man or sender, whoever you are going to hell, you need to repent fast. Repent fast. Repent. Draw near unto him. Repent. The kingdom of God is at hand. We are in the fifth trumpet. The Antichrist, which is the devil, Revelation 12:9. Don't let them let you believe it's some man from the east. All of that is just a whole bunch of lies from the Satanist and the Luciferian. The Bible says he is the devil. Who is wanted to sit in Jesus' seat? Ezekiel 28, throughout the Word of God, Satan. He is the son of perdition, the book of Daniel all the way down to Revelation. He is the only one who is being condemned. He is the only one who is being cast out. The prince of darkness, prince of this world. He is the prince of darkness. He is the one who controls the worldliness. When you look at them, look at the awards and the awards and TV and all of that stuff, and the effigy, what they call it, the Satan idol called Oscar, everything got a name. The satanic triangles that they use. Look at them and the stars. You don't understand yet that they are Luciferian? Just go on Google. Because Google is satanic anyway. Go there and put Luciferian symbols and handshakes and you'll see it for yourself. Verse 7. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, his evil thoughts, his wicked imagination, his greed, his lust for money, lasciviousness. Lasciviousness in the church. Superfluity in the church. Pride. Lift it up. God only speaks to me. God told me to tell you, liar. Mouthpiece of faith, I'm not buying you. I don't pray. I told a young lady who just got delivered yesterday. She got delivered over the weapons. I do not pray, and you don't need to pray and entertain demons. When they come speaking satanic things to you, tell them I reject. Just look at them. Pretty, smooth, and simple. I reject you in the name of Jesus. I walk away. Get thee behind me, Satan. I walk away. Don't listen to the satanic lies. Knock, 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 soul hunters. Look into who they should devour. Agents of Satan, mouthpiece of Satan. Wicked imagination, evil thoughts, hatred. They hate your neighbors. They hate everything that love God. They're full of hate and superfluity, pride, ambition, prideful, prideful woman in the church, gossiping woman, lying woman, they sit in a choir, they sit on a usher board, they're liars, they're hypocrites. They fight, they sleep with one another husband. The deacon and the deaconess, they're fighting. The elders fight in church too. I've seen so much throwdown in churches. It's a shame. Then you run to one church and they want you to confess all your sins, how much men you slept with. And the pastor sit there and then you look. She used to be a stripper and a harlot. And when you look, they pass you around. You're sleeping with all the different deacons. You're sleeping with everybody. You got to stand in that hearing. And you got to come in so I can plant the seed of the Lord in you. Which seed I wish, Lord? Let us take off our clothes. That's what they will tell you. There was a young lady who came to me for deliverance. First couple years ago, like 10 years ago, the story was so sad. The things that she went through with some so-called people of God, but they're not but devils, Luciferians. And her mother had a lot to do with it. She said what they did, they locked her in a room in her, and she had to have sex with six pastors. And one of them took a hanger and molested her, and she wanted to commit suicide. So she already went and purchased a gun to blow her brains out and all of that. And through deliverance, she got deliverance. And I told her, run away from your mother. Run away. Oh! You see, there are certain people under certain covenants, and they have to sacrifice their children. You see, you have no idea when you see a church because it says Christian or because it says Jesus and Reverend, you think that's God in there. Sometimes it's a synagogue of Satan. Jesus called them the synagogue of Satan. Synagogue was only given to the Hebrew people, not to us. There's no Christian temple supposed to use the name synagogue. And it's you can research it, and you can Google it, and Google have a lot of evil on it too. It says here in verse 10, let the wicked forsake his way, or her way, and the unrighteous man his, or his thoughts. Let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. This is the time for forgiveness. After you bow down and you worship the hands of Christ and receive the mark of the beast, and you go to the evil gathering, believing a lie that you're going to fly away, it's going to be too late for you. There's a seven trumpet blow, you no longer in the flesh. You instantly won't be in your spiritual body. At the seven trumpet, the beginning of the millennia will start, the 1,000 year of teaching. The 1,000 year of preaching. I just want certain people in my class. I've asked the Lord to give me certain of these big mouth preachers. I want them in my class. Because I'm going to beat them with the rod of iron. Do you know that you shall judge angels? Do you know that you sit in heavenly places? Who do you think you are? What the mouthpiece of Satan and the child abuser and the rapist told you you're going to be? That evil satanic program of your destiny, I demolish it right now in the name of Jesus. I cast it down in the name of Jesus. I bind up every wicked word and every wicked word that was planted in you from your childhood. I bind it and cast it down by fire in the name of Jesus. Do you know who you really are in Christ Jesus? Do you understand that you are sitting in heavenly places in Christ Jesus? Do you comprehend the responsibility and the power that God has given you through the spiritual gifts? You have no idea. And then you walk around, all cast down, oh my soul. Please, woman and men of God, lift up your head and push your chest out and brace back your shoulder. You are a chosen vessel of God. You are a child of God, a child of the King. You are an ambassador, a chosen one, the elect of God. Walk in power. Walk in what God has ordained you. Don't let the devil children speak to you anyhow. Don't let the devil mouthpiece tell you any lie from the pits of hell. Don't let them bring their stupid Bible that they wrote by the Satanists telling you to read this and read that. Repeat them sharply. Because the King James Version is the only version that's not being watered down. People of God, wake up. You are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer because Jesus overcame this wicked, evil world. And he came in the flesh. He didn't have to come in the flesh, but he came in the flesh. As a holy sacrifice, as an atonement of God, a one-time atonement. We don't need no goat blood and cow blood and lamb blood. We don't need no sheep blood. We don't need that anymore because the blood of the high priest, Melchizedek. The blood of the high priest, Melchizedek. The blood shed on Calvary for one time to bridge the gap between hell and heaven. I say he died on the cross for the church belongs to Jesus. Every soul, everything that I pray belongs to him. I don't care who owns the lease and the title and the land. It belongs to him. He is Lord. The cornerstone that was rejected, he was rejected by man and by woman. He was rejected by his own. He was rejected by the street. And today they rejected the cornerstone that was rejected has become the chief cornerstone. His name is Jesus. He is the head of the church. There's nobody here saying there's a head, but that stupid religion somewhere up there who they like to beat children, them nuns, and torture children. They are not the head of the church. There's no man or woman down here saying they're the head. And they're the church universal. It is Jesus is the head of the head, the church. Not those superfluity, flesh and lasciviousness and pridefulness and rudeness, cockiness. They think that the devil children, they're so cocky, they hate God children. They walk up to you, they want to talk to you anywhere, and you receive it. Rebuke them sharply. That's what Timothy said. Rebuke them in the name of Jesus. So I rebuke, I reject everyone. Go back to sender. I reject every evil word. I don't want to know about your false religion. I don't want to know about your false. I rebuke you, reject them. You are the impossible. You are the chosen one, not them. They are soul hunters. Come and join here. This is the way we do it. This is the way God said we all should do it in the Bible. Not according to put a rag on your head. Wear only dresses to your ankle. Devil is a liar. Man-made philosophies. Verse 8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts. This is what God's telling you. Your way of thinking, your way of seeing, the way of your imagination is not the imagination of God. God don't think like us. God don't act like us. God don't walk like us. God is not. We are not gods. We are his property because he purchased us. He made us. He gave us the breath of life. He ordained us, but we are not equal to God. Who telling you equal to God? Who told you what God and I'm making? The devil. Because that's what he did to Eve. He told her, and it was the woman who was beguiled first. It wasn't the man. It was the woman because he told her, the day you eat, your eyes shall be open and you shall be as God. That God don't want you to know like this. And when she ate it, did she really eat the apple? No. When you study the Hebrew, what happened, the word touch is mean naga. And naga means sexual intercourse. Just go and put the word touch in Hebrew. What does the word touch in Hebrew? It means naga. N-A-G-A. Naga. Hold is seduce. What is seduction? How does a woman or a man seduce the opposite sex? Sensuality. Words. Women love words. Romance. Which apple? What apple did they eat? Where is the apple? Where in what verse where they get the apple? Which fruit? Have you ever lived in Europe? You know what they call fruit, right? Okay. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. Verse 9. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than the ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Higher. Abundantly higher. All God wants is good for his children. All God wants us is to live in peace and in harmony. All God, but the devil is the one who foiled the plan. It was not God's intention for us to live in a crime, in fear, as dying and sickness and disease and generic disorder and murder and rape and people enslaving people and from other nations and making them slaves and beating up and kidnapping and all of this wickedness, incest. Hey, that was not the plan of God. God did not design this earth in the book of Genesis and made us to come down here to live like this. But it was the plan of the devil. It was the plan of the devil and his fallen angels. That's one third. And in the book of Genesis, it said the sons of God, the angelical beings, the angels came down and they saw the daughters of Adam, and they raped them and corrupt them and snatch them. It's called rapere. Snatch, kidnap, rape, or burn them, impregnated. Even some of them started their own tribes, Romulus and Remus, and a whole lot of them. Hittites, parasites, Jebusites. Come on. Have you studied the first five books? Why it is the pastors are refusing to put the foundation on the new members? There's no foundation teaching. The first five books, there's no foundation because they themselves don't understand the first five books. They themselves have no spiritual anointing to understand the first five books. So how are they going to teach it when they're Luciferian? It is not important, they say. It's not important to read the first five books of the Old Testament. It is not important to study Revelation. Just go in and just start here, sorry, in between. How are you going to get into the in-between when you don't understand? If you don't get the first five books down front in your spirit, if you don't have the foundation laid, you will not be able to understand the latter. You're not going to be able to comprehend the latter. Because God has a chronological order as event. And we see what took place in the garden and the effects of Genesis chapter 6. When the fallen angels came down and mixed their DNA with human beings and start procreating among themselves. They start having children with flesh women. With mortal. So the immortals came down to have sex with the mortals because they love sex. Any type of sex. Sex, even the offspring love to have sex with children. They love to molest and rape. They love the same sex as the Luciferian order. Called perversion. Verse 10. For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven, and return it not hither, but water the earth, and make it bring forth the bud, and bud, that it may give seed to sow to the sower, and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of the mouth, out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void. But it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things which whereto I sent it. You see, the word of God is not going to return void. The time we spent here praying and breaking down the word of God teaching is not a wasted time on this prayer line. Because the word of God go out in the cosmos. And when the word of God go out, it's going to penetrate. It's like a two-edged sword. The word of God is going to go out. And as the word of God go out, the word of God has to accomplish certain things in people and in human beings' lives. So as we study and I preach, that gospel go out. It goes in the airways because then it goes on YouTube. And it goes on the Resurrecting Your Spirit ministry on the YouTube. And the people will go and they will read the titles and they will listen to the word of God. So that word of God is going to accomplish whatever God wanted to accomplish. It's going to reach to whoever he wants to reach. When you are an ambassador, you're going to travel. And the ambassador means I have a commission. I'm accomplished. I'm going to go wherever God sent me to go. Man can't stop you. Your girlfriend and your ex-enemies can't stop you. The devil and self cannot stop you. But what God has ordained you to be from the foundation of the earth, when you stood against Satan and the coup d'etat, and you stood against, in that coup d'etat, you stood against Satan, and you fought the fight in the first earth age, and you earned your rank. You earned the rank to be called an ambassador in the war and the first earth age. I want to stir up your spirit. I want to bring it back to your remembrance. I want you to understand that God is the one who chose you. I say I want you to understand that the power is the power of God. We are not independent from Jesus. We are not independent from the Word. We are not independent from God and His commandments. But we all in all are children of God, redeemed by the blood of the high priest. Who it is, that certain cornerstone that was rejected has become the chief cornerstone. His name is Yeshua. The Lamb of God, Emmanuel, Jesus the Christ, the Son of the Dove, the Barayona, the Savior of the world. His name is Jesus, and there's no other condition to enter into his kingdom, because he is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man calleth by him, except through him, by him, and what is ordained. Amen. Anything else will fall. Everything else will fail. Man's tradition will fail. Philosophy will fail on that day. Be careful. Do not submit yourself to the Luciferians, these soul hunters and star hunters, going around with their evil little liturgy knocking on your door, telling you come up here, you studied your ancestors and worship your ancestors. You reject them, say, I reject you and walk off. Are we washed by the blood of Jesus? The blood of Jesus, I bind you. I rebuke you. I reject you and keep on going. You got power over them. You don't bow to no man. You don't bow to no Luciferian. You don't bow. You only bow to God in prayer. Thank you, Father, for this day. Thank you for this hour. Thank you that you taught your children the truth. Thank you for your word. Give us strength, O Lord. Give us power of the Holy Spirit, power in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Give us and strengthen us. Strengthen our mind, our body, and our soul. Strengthen the mind. Give us the power of the Holy Spirit. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. You shall stand in what God has ordained for you. You shall walk in what God has ordained for your destiny. The devil can't touch you. Your enemies can't touch you. They cannot put fear in you. They can't do no voodoo to you. They cannot cast no spell on you, because you know how to fight them back. Anything that the enemy sent against you, it shall return to the sender. I said, bounce back, go back where you came from and backfire against every satanic ordination. They can't do you nothing. You are ambassador. You are in Christ Jesus. You more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer. You overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. You got the word in you. You living and walking in what God has ordained. They can't touch you. You tell them, you can't touch me. You can't touch my family. You can't touch me. You can't touch my home. You can't touch me. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. 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 Rebuke you, Satan. Rebuke Satan. Rebuke Satan right now. I rebuke you, Satan. Every evil thought, every evil message, every evil report, every negative report, any satanic prophecy, any satanic covering, I rebuke it. Any satanic manipulation, I rebuke it in the dreams. physical, anybody, any of my enemies that appear unto me and come to me talking, I tell them, get behind me, Satan, I reject you. I reject your lies. I reject your hypocrisy. Reject them. Reject them and walk in what God has ordained. You see, when you stand up to your enemies, they will say, oh, fear will come upon your enemies. Fear of God. He said, your enemies shall flee 7 ways. I said, let God arise and my enemies be scattered. Let God arise and my enemies be scattered. Let God arise and my enemies be scattered. That's Psalm 64. Let God arise and my enemies be scattered. Let God arise. God will arise and your enemies be scattered. They will flee from you. Even when you rebuke a witch, if you is a person who's been doing witchcraft year after year and doing wickedness to you, and you stand up and you rebuke them and say, I rebuke you, do you know that witch can die? They will drop and die, get sick and die. Anybody who's doing witchcraft to you, rebuke them. Rebuke them, say, I rebuke you. When they call you on the evil phone and send you evil in, say, I rebuke you. Rebuke him. Rebuke them. Rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you. Let them go back to the sender. Everything that they've done shall return unto them. And they're the one who's going to drop and die, not you. Every ditch, every hole that they dug for you, every evil sneer of the enemy, every evil trick of the enemy going to return unto them. Bounce back. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire. Return to sender. Go back to your sender. Go back to the evil originator. Go back to the one who started it. Go back to point A. Return to the sender in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We honor you. We glorify you. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you, Lord, for our Lord and our Savior. We lift him up. He's high and lifted up. Oh, the Lord bless you and encourage you today. The Lord keep you. The Lord guide you and protect you in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. And remember, be blessed and be encouraged. And remember, rebuke Satan. Defeat him in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I beseech you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. Tell them just like that. I beseech you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. Because the war that we are in is a spiritual war. You have to use the word of God through your mouth. You got to open up your mouth. You got to pray and you got to rebuke them. Rebuke them even to their face. When they come, they're going to come and present themselves to you. They're going to come and see, let me go see what's going on. What's going on? Something in the physical, something going on. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, angels of Satan. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, I reject you, I cancel you out, I destroy every evil work of the enemy. In Jesus' mighty name. Remember, the name that was given above all name is the name of Jesus. Visit our site, resurrectingyourspiritministry.org, or spiritualselfdefense.com, or also you can visit us at YouTube. You can go to Resurrecting Your Spirit YouTube, and we got a lot of the prayer points on from here on the prayer line on YouTube where they are listening, because we got to keep spreading the word of deliverance. God bless you. God keep you in Jesus' mighty name. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen and amen. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah! 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 Holy Spirit, fire! 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 God! Fire of God consume my enemies. The fire of the Holy Spirit fight for you. The fire of the Holy Spirit in a wall of protection around you. The fire of the Holy Spirit is your high tower. The fire of the Holy Spirit will consume the devil and his demons. The fire of the Holy Spirit will swallow up all your enemies and consume them. The fire of the Holy Spirit will fight for you and defend you. The fire of the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, fire, fire, follow me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. You can't fight me. You can't fight me. Greater is he that's in me than who is in the world. I said, greater is he that's in me than who is in the world. I say the kingdom of darkness got to be demolished. The kingdom of darkness and the members of the satanic kingdom gonna fall on their knees. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Let the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah! 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 The word of God said in the book of James chapter 4, resist the devil. I said resist the devil. Resist the devil and he shall flee from you. Resist him above all. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but by principalities, powers, rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. I said the war is a spiritual war. The war is not a pawn of war. The war is not a cussed out, pulled out, drank out, punched out, kicked out war. But the war is a spiritual war. You want to fight the war according to what the Father said in the Bible. That's the way you fight the war. Singing psalms, praising, fasting, and praying, and spreading the word. The word is your weapon. I said the word of God is your weapon. I say the word of God is your weapon. I say you are a battle axe. You are the battle axe of the Lord. And with thee, God will break down. Break down, destroy nations. I said, you are about life for the Lord. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Holy Spirit, fire, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Like the day of Pentecost, fire, fall on me. Hallelujah. I said, you are a child of God. You are precious in his eyes. You are a child of God. Children of God, you have the power. You have power of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is upon you. He has called you to heal the brokenhearted, to build the waste places, to preach the gospel and deliver his people. People of God, you are somebody in Christ Jesus. You have the power of the Holy Spirit. You got the power in your tongue. Death and life is in your tongue. You have the power to call judgment upon your enemies. You got the power to condemn every wicked deed, every wicked heart. You see, you're sitting in heavenly places and you don't even know the power that God has given you. God has given you all power. Jesus said, greater works we shall do. I said, greater works we shall do. Don't be afraid of the enemy. Don't be afraid of them in the physical realm. Don't be afraid of them in the spirit. Because you have dominion and power over both. You got dominion and power in the physical realm. You got dominion and power in the spiritual realm. Maintain a clean heart. Live righteously. Live in truth. Live in the spirit in Jesus Christ's name. Let your profession of Christianity be a true profession. Live holy. God is holy and you must live holy. Christians are not perfect. And many days they judge us and they condemn us. But God said, for every judgment they call against you, you got the power to reverse it. You have power. I said, God has given you power. God has given you power. He will fight for you. He will fight for you financially, for your marriage, for your fiancé. He will fight for your children. He will fight for you. He will fight for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. When the battle comes, you will know. You will know when you are in a war. You will know when you are under attack. You will know. God does not hide nothing from us. God is a true God. God has chosen you. You are a chosen vessel. Let nobody tell you nothing different. You walk as an ambassador. Raise your back up. Push your chest out. Lift up your head. You are a child of God, a royal priesthood, set aside for good works, for good things. You are more than a conqueror. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. I say they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. The only way you can overcome this wicked world and the wickedness in this world, the spirit of confusion, is through the word of God. The counselor can't do